That said, we now have our next presentation. Should brands focus on changing the world or the shareholder fortune? We have Mr. Hitesh Bhagia with us, Head Express Studio, Indian Express. And on all your behalf, I would like to invite Hitesh onto the stage.
Honest confession, it's damn unnerving to come on the stage after people who have a head full of grey hair or no hair have already kind of passed through and shared. But it's been very fascinating to kind of listen to how all different brand owners look at building purpose in the brand very differently. For some, it's product features and how they're helping the users, and for some, it's the CSR that they're doing. My job here is to kind of share on Indian Express's behalf that how is that we as a publisher can help you communicate whatever purpose you as brands finally identify. Can we have the AV, please?
खोज में निकल तू किस लिए हताश है तू चल तेरे वजूद की समय को भी तलाश है समय को भी तलाश है
सो दैट लास्ट बिट ओवर हियर वाज प्रवीण कुमार द गाय हु नरेटेड द पोएम प्रवीण कुमार इज एन एक्स नेवी कमांडो हु गॉट शॉट while he was engaging with terrorists during the 26/11 Bombay attacks last year. He took 4 bullets. His story is one of courage and one of inspiration, but unfortunately not many people knew of him. Until recently, last week, when we decided to amplify the story in form of an interview that happened between Sachin Tendulkar and Praveen Kumar, this video, this post, became the second most popular post on Facebook across the world within 24 hours of going live. It reached out to millions of people and triggered thousands of positive conversations. So the event that we did on which, when we played this video, was last week on 26/11. It was at the Gateway of India, Bombay. We had the Honorable Chief Minister of Maharashtra, Shri Devendra Fadnavis as the chief guest. We had Amitabh Bachchan, Prasoon Joshi and the likes gracing the event, and we had partners like Facebook helping us build this event into a big one. The idea of this event also came a while ago when, you know, we met Kia Share, an American national who lost her daughter and her husband at the Trident Hotel the same day. And they had come over here for a meditational retreat. We spoke with her, and what she told us was very powerful. She said that obviously she was shattered, you know, after the incident, but she decided one day that, you know, there is no point living with a lot of poison in her heart, and she has decided to kind of forgive the people who were involved in this. And she wants to now focus her time and energy spreading the message of love and compassion in our society, which is much needed. And this got us thinking as a publisher brand that, you know, there is so much to learn from these people. So why not we kind of go down and, you know, talk to more such people who have been affected and try and learn from them that, you know, what are the human qualities that we can today pick up and we can pass on Because today, considering how the climate is, we are much in need of, you know, such conversations, positive conversations happening. And we did this event this year. And the brands that supported us in doing this event were again the brands that, you know, at the heart, at the core, had the following thought that, you know, can we facilitate positive conversations? So this is what, you know, as a publisher, is that what we can do? We can, you know, enable brands to communicate whatever their core values are while doing something very, very meaningful at the same time. So this is from the New Yorker, I think. This very kind of clearly sums up, you know, why we are here today. So for people that probably who can't read it at the back, you know, there's this father sitting with his children, and obviously behind everything has gone wrong, and he's saying, yes, the planet got destroyed, but for a beautiful moment in time, we created a lot of value for shareholders. And this kind of brings us to the question that, you know, what are brands responsible for? Are they responsible for changing the world, or are they responsible for changing the shareholder fortune? Or as, you know, Buddha said once, you know, is there a middle path wherein, you know, both can happen simultaneously? So through the day today, we have heard that, you know, brands do realize that there is an importance of purpose being at the core to kind of drive the business. And there are multiple studies out there which kind of prove the same. Whether, you know, there was this first study by Millward Brown again, I think which was mentioned earlier also in the day, that brands that in consumers' mind have a clear purpose linked to them, 80% of those brands typically end up outperforming the market. Another study by Nielsen which says that, you know, people are willing to pay a premium, again something which got mentioned, I mean, people are willing to pay a premium for brands that they think are responsible brands. And I think the best of all was the study which Unilever released last year, which was called actually Making Purpose Pay, which suggested that they divided the brands into two buckets within the Unilever portfolio. And they found out that, you know, the brands that had a clear purpose or a sustainable goal linked to them, for example, something like Dove, for example, which is not just a soap, but it's also about nurturing self-esteem of women, grew much faster than the rest of the business. On another note, they kind of didn't show, you know, which were the other brands in their portfolio which didn't have a purpose. I'm assuming, you know, probably Lux would be there, which kind of does the complete opposite. But the idea is that, you know, clearly having a purpose, there is sufficient evidence around there from what we've heard today and from the reports out there that, you know, clearly having a purpose helps you connect emotionally better with your consumers. It's high time that we stop looking at consumers just as, say, you know, a pair of armpits looking for a deodorant, or, you know, a head of hair looking for a shampoo. They are real people, they have a real life, they have real anxieties, and they have real concerns. And when a brand which has a core purpose at its heart, they are able to communicate emotionally with these people and connect better. I think while having a purpose clearly is good, what is also important is that, is our purpose as a brand very clear, very simple? And also, is it well known? And I think we've reached a stage where, this was discussed earlier as well, that, you know, we need to move away as brands from the creative excellence of, you know, doing those 30-second ad spots for whatever is the flavor of the season around then, to content excellence. Creating content which can trigger conversations, which can help a brand gain significance and gain trust in a user's mind. And I think as Indian Express, that's where we come in, that as a publisher, which has a reach pan-India, we can help brand identify these positive stories, we can help brands develop on these positive stories, and we can help brands distribute these positive stories. We as a publisher, which is present across different languages, across different regions, across different interest groups. We are always happy to lend our credible voice and a large community of readers and work with brands and work with their creative agencies to help get the message out. So clearly, you know, I mean, we need to put the why of what we are doing before the what of what we are doing. And Indian Express can help us, is willing to work with the brands on this journey. I think we missed on the slide, yeah. So I would just like to end with this. You know, this is a quote by Kailash Satyarthi, and he kind of basically says that, you know, we often fail as a society, but, you know, while we are failing as a society, we do offer glimpses of greatness. And I think if as brands, if as publishers, we can get together, we can identify these moments of greatness and we can amplify them so the conversation start becoming around them, I think we've done our job. Thank you.